Specials. Introducing the United States Marine Team. Sergeant Rodney Mitchell, Lieutenant Colonel Paul Wilson, Corporal Michael Mack, Staff Sergeant John Bloodworth, and Sergeant Bill Fitzgerald. Ready for action. Battling for victory against the United States Navy Team. Officer Julie Harbour, Petty Officer Terrell Christopher, Lieutenant Midge Burke, Petty Officer Michael Nolan, and Petty Officer Jerry Ferdinand. On your marks, let's start the Family Feud Battle of the Armed Forces with the star of Family Feud, Ray Cohn.
Welcome back to the United States Marine Corps. Thank you so very much, and thank you for tuning in. If you've just joined us at home, if you've not been watching the shows, we've got exciting feuds happening. We've got the five branches of the military going against each other in a very special Family Feud version. Only one of the five will be called Family Feud Champions in a very special playoff. Right now, the Army has cinched a berth in that playoff. The Air Force is standing in the wings. But today, that balance will be decided because the Marines, if they win with a score of 339 points or more, they are in the finals. The Navy can be the spoiler. Right now, I welcome the United States Marines. Oh. Rodney, Sergeant Rodney Mitchell. I might have got a little lengthy in speech, but most importantly, you need to win big today. Who did you bring to help you do that?
I brought Lieutenant Colonel Paul Wilson.
Yes.
Corporal Michael Matt.
You know what? You're really losing them. You know that? I mean, I used to have them. Big deep ones.
All right.
Who else did you bring?
Staff Sergeant John Bloodworth.
There you go.
And Sergeant Bill Fitzpatrick.
You are playing for a very worthy charity, if you would tell those watching. He's playing for which is the Navy Marine Corps Relief Society,
right.
Which is a wonderful charity. But the one service that could stop you from playing in the finals is the United States Navy, ladies and gentlemen, who would very much like to take $10,000 for their charity today. Now, Julie, who did you bring with you? We have Petty Officer Julie Harbour.
Yes.
Who did you bring with you?
Well, I brought along Petty Officer Terrell Christopher.
Welcome back.
Lieutenant Midge Berth.
Welcome.
Petty Officer Michael Nolan.
Nice to see you again.
And Petty Officer Jerry Ferdinand.
Yeah. We welcome you. The Navy Marine Corps Relief Society. The Navy is first.
Yeah.
All right, but you absolutely have a great charity, and there's nothing... I don't guess there's really an older rivalry maybe than the Navy and the Marines, huh? Well, we're going to see right now, because we're going to play The Feud. Let's go. The first team to $300 will win the game and play fast money for the $10,000. Good luck to both. Rodney, you don't seem impressed.
Not.
All right.
Neither am I, Ray.
She's not afraid of you, she says. The crowd says, We ask 100 men this first question, and we put the top six answers on the board. Believe me, ladies and gentlemen, I feel the tension. Try to find the most popular answer. We ask 100 men. Name a fib men tell about themselves at singles bars. Julie? Don't say it. Hold it right there. Rodney, name a fib that men tell about themselves at singles bars.
I'm not married.
Rodney says they say they're not married.
Good!
Number one!
Good.
Marital status.
Good.
Lieutenant Colonel. What do you say? The survey was asked of 100 men. A fib that men tell about themselves at singles bars. Now, I know Marines wouldn't do this.
Their occupation.
All right. Let me see their occupation. The Marines are playing tough. Michael. What do you say?
Their age.
Their age?
Yeah.
All right. Show me the age. There it is, number three. Sergeant, good to see you back.
Good to be back.
What do you say men would lie about at a singles bar?
Men will lie about.
You could say age.
The rage? It's a good answer. It's number three. So, you know, but take another answer. Think of something else.
No, their birthday.
Their birth date.
Yes.
Which would be like the sign, because maybe a girl likes an Aries, and so you'd lie and say you are. Let me see their birthday. Bill,
what's going on?
A fib men tell about themselves at singles bars.
Their income.
Yeah.
Let's go. Yes.
Men sometimes have a way of lying about their income.
Yes.
There it is.
Yes.
Financial status. We got two answers left. Rodney, you're grinning, you're smiling. Are you that friendly in the military?
No, not for real.
What is your occupation in the military?
Honestly, I'm a Marine Corps drill instructor.
As well? We did this one.
Right.
Just so I can just have a comparison. Step right over this way. Let me say that you're my drill instructor. I'm a boot trainee, and I'm supposed to be on the mark at 6 o'clock, and it's 6:01, and I am the last one there. And what would you say to me? It's a good thing I'm wearing one of those new adult disposable diapers. That's all I want to say. A fib that men tell about themselves at singles bars. Rodney,
children.
They tell?
No children.
They have no children. Let me see. I have no children. It's two strikes. I'm shaking. All right, what do you say, Colonel? To stay alive.
Their interests outside of the bar scene.
They may lie about their outside interests.
Yeah. Yeah.
Not their name. You will have $79 if you know a fib men tell about themselves at singles bars, Jerry.
How many women they've been with?
How many women they've been with, Michael?
Where they're from.
Where they're from, Mitch?
Their sexual prowess.
Their sexual prowess. Terrell?
Sexual prowess.
Sexual prowess. Julie Witham are out on your own.
Well, I gotta go with the majority. Sexual prowess.
Sexual prowess. Yeah. You stole in the bank if we see sexual prowess. Stole it right from the Marines. One of the things, Marines, that men sometimes fib about, number six. Popularity. You'll be very popular if you're right here after these very important messages. We've had a great show.
Match game.
Hollywood Squares.
Two great games.
That game great together.
We're off and running.
The Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Weeknights at 10.
On Buzzer.
I am so pleased.
All included. Discover why over 1 million happy sleepers sleep on a Nectar mattress.
We are back. The United States Navy, $79. The Marine, zero. Here we go, Colonel. With another face-off. We put the top seven answers on the board. We ask 100 people this question. Name a place that makes you shiver just from the thought of being there. Colonel?
North Pole.
He said the North. Some spit came flying, Colonel, all the way over there. But if a colonel spits on me, it is okay. Show me the North Pole. No, it's not there. It would make me shiver. Terrell, a place that makes you shiver just from the thought of being there.
Pool.
A pool? Pretty scary, all right? Show me the pool. No one move. Listen to me carefully on this now, Michael. I want you to name a place that makes you shiver just from the thought of being there.
A funeral home.
Let me see a funeral home. Number two, no one move. Now, hold on.
I got it.
We go to Midge. One answer gives the Navy control, a place that makes you shiver just from the thought of being there.
A cemetery.
Could it be cemetery? The Navy trying desperately to spoil the Marines. You need to think of a steal and take as big a bank as you can get. Michael, what would make you shiver just from the thought of being there?
Dentist's office.
Let me see the dentist's office.
Woo!
Jerry?
I have to say doctor's office.
Maybe a doctor's office. Not there. You think of that steal, Marines. Julie?
How about being in court?
Maybe.
Being tried in court or something like that. Yeah.
How about being in court? It's only $44, but you don't want to let him get it, Terrell. Can you name a place makes you shiver just by thinking about being there?
War.
Mm.
Ooh, good answer.
Still alive on this question if we see war. Not there. You can get in the game, Marines, if you name a place that makes you shiver. Just from the thought of being there, every dollar could turn out to be critical for you. So what do you say, Bill?
Alaska.
Alaska.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
The hospital.
Hospital.
Haunted house.
Haunted house.
House.
Rodney,
jail.
What would our survey have said? 100 jail. Average
jail.
People.
Jail.
Jail.
You say jail. He says jail. $44 coming this way if we see shiver from the thought of being in jail. The Marines take the bank. Navy, this would have built the bank up if we had known the shivering thoughts of being in number three. Haunted house. Said by?
We had it. We had it.
All right, said by John and number four. Hospital. And number six. Caves. We're coming right back. You don't have to shiver because there's a lot of fun and excitement. Good.
Small steps can create big obstacles. Quality in the USA.
Happy buzzer birthday to board game pioneer Milton Bradley.
We're shooting right now. The Navy, $79, trying to stop the Marines with 44. Here we go. Another face off. We doubled the dollar value. The top six answers are on the board. We ask 100 people, name something besides food or drink that you can buy from vending machines. Mitch?
Cigarettes.
Let me see cigarettes. That is number one. You will think of the Steel Marines. Michael, we're looking for something besides food and drink that you can buy from vending machines.
Grooming utensils.
The judge, with an attitude, says he wants a specific answer.
Combs.
Combs. It's a good thing to buy. Show me combs. You know, Gene, I always knew someday I'd make the survey. What do you say, Jerry?
Toys. They sell those little toys.
Toys?
Those little plastic things.
Little toys. There it is. $132. Marines, this would be a very fine bank to steal. Julie, when you finish praying, if you could just answer.
Well, with the way things are today, how about condoms?
Now, my name is Combs, and I'm just wondering if somebody turns in, if condoms is up there, and they see combs, toys, condoms on that survey. Let me see a condom.
Yeah!
Woo-hoo! 158, what do you say, Carol? No strikes. What do you say?
Things you can buy.
Things you can buy besides food or drink. 3 seconds. Take a guess. One strike only. Please think of that, Steel Marines. What do you say, Midge? Yeah.
Chewing gum.
She says chewing gum.
Yes, yes.
Didn't make the survey.
There.
You just need one answer to take a big lead. If Michael doesn't know, you can keep it going, Michael.
Tampons.
Yeah, that's a good answer.
She goes, condom. He goes, tampons. But you know, you're still on your way to a clean sweep if we do see a tampon.
Come on, it's there!
Three strikes. Marines, something besides food or drink you can buy from vending machines. You can steal, Bill.
Cigars.
Cigars, John.
Magazine.
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 Magazines from vending machines.
Perfume.
Perfume. You can go with them or out on your own, Sergeant. This is very important. What could be the answer?
Perfume.
From a vending machine.
Cigars.
What do you say?
Cigars.
Cigars? Is that different than cigarettes, Judge?
That's
you take cigars over the other answers. 158 coming this way if we see cigars. No, sir. The Navy takes that back. What do you think? Did you want to say that? Rodney says he wanted to say detergent. I don't know. Number four, vending machines. Stamp. Number six. Soap. Would have got you the bank. You should have went with your gut. The Navy, 237. The Marines, 44. Here we go. Let's go. We will triple the dollar value. Top four answers on the board. Listen carefully. The Navy going for the spoil. The Marines need this question. Name a continent that touches two oceans. John?
A continent that touches two oceans is...
Don't say a word.
Europe.
He says the Europe continent. Let me see Europe. Don't move. I come over here. Bill, listen to me. Name a continent that touches two oceans.
North American continent.
Let me see the North American continent. It is number one, and the Marines have control. Triple dollar value. Rodney, name a continent that touches two oceans.
Australia.
He says the Australian continent. $273 in this bank. Paul, your team can win. Will you get enough to put you in the finals? A continent that touches two oceans.
We want to try South America.
Let me see the South American continent. $282. It would be very close, Judge, if you give me this answer. Michael, will you have the 339 points you need to play the Army? A continent that touches two oceans for the game and the championship final.
Alaska.
He said Alaskan continent. Let me see. The Alaskan continent. Yes. Second most popular answer, John. If you could give me the answer you tried to say up there, a continent that touches two oceans for the game.
The Arab countries.
You got to tell me the name of the continent. He says, show me the Arab countries. Two strikes. Navy, think of a steal. Bill, you're controlling your own destiny. If you give me number two, you're going to take that bank. It's your only chance at getting a large enough bank to get in the finals. Continent that touches two oceans.
Africa.
If number two is African continent, you will win this game. But will there be enough points to give you 339, your magic number? Show me African continent. It's there! 297 gives you 341 by $2. The Marines are in the finals. You are in the finals. I'm sorry, Navy. I need two players right now for $10,000. Bill, you can hold your head up high, first or second. Bye-bye. We're coming right back with Bill, who knew the African continent, playing fast money for $10,000. Don't you go away. Good job.
All this week.
Good morning.
Have breakfast with Buzzer. Weekday morning starting at 9. It's the most important TV of the day.
Hold the applause down here. People are sleeping.
This tree has shared moments of...
Go to trysheets.com to save over $100 today.
We are back with the Marines going for $10,000 for the Navy Marine Corps Relief Society. As we put 15 seconds on the clock, we wish Bill much luck. We ask 100 people these five questions, but the first one we ask 100 men. What's the best sport to take up if you want to meet someone of the opposite sex?
Tennis.
Which color M&M do you eat first?
Brown.
Something specific you do to your car?
Wash it.
A kind of pet bird?
Parakeet.
A specific relative you phone frequently?
Mother.
Turn around here. Right. We asked 100 men the best sport to take up if you want to meet someone of the opposite sex. Bill, who knew the surprising answer to win the game, said... Tennis. Our survey said... 4-3-4. This was a really insightful thing to you. Which color M&M do you eat first? You said you love the brown M&Ms. Our survey said 19.
All right.
All right. Something specific you do to your car, you said? You wash it. What did the survey say? 39.
Yes.
At 100 right now.
Yes. All the way, guys. All
a
the way.
Kind of bird, you said? A parakeet. Our survey said 49. Right now, before I even ask this question, I'm going to go to the judge. How are we on time? Can he get this by himself? Is it possible? It is possible that you could get 200 points all by yourself. And if so, I want to know the time that we're in. Because if so, we're going to have a lot of fun with your partner. 1 minute. Here we go. I asked you a specific relative that you telephone frequently. You said you can telephone your mother. Now, if 49 people said mother, the United States Marines will have $10,000. What did our survey say? You! They got the money. Now, he has no idea. He thinks... All right. Here we go. Bring him out. All right, come on, Sergeant. All right, good luck to you, John.
Let's go, buddy.
John,
let's go.
I want you to look straight ahead. John, you need to do this. Your partner choked. He only got 36 points, but you can do it if you give me all number one answers. Put 20 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, John. You can bring it home for the relief fund.
Okay.
Name the third planet from the sun.
The third planet from the sun is Mars.
Name any lunar lake.
Missouri Lake.
Popular game show host.
Ray.
Of Curly Larry and Moe, name Curly's wife of the Three Stooges. Quickly.
Any one of them.
Quickly. Could be. Say pass.
Martha.
All right, Martha, turn around. Let's see how you did. Check it out.
You suffering from pain? Or go online now to get two bottles of Omega XL for just
$39.95. Ooh! This Halloween, treat those goblins to a new snack-sized Bar None. The candy bar with a light, crispy texture and a rich, chocolatey taste. Hershey's Bar None. 2000 Flushes brand automatic toilet bowl cleaners. The easy way to keep your toilet sparkling, clean, and fresh up to 4 months. Hamburger Helper, cheeseburger macaroni with oodles of noodles and a creamy cheese sauce. Hamburger Helper helps you make a great meal. Actifed, the full prescription strength medicine that helps relieve the stuffy, drippy misery of a head cold. For effective relief, take Actifed. Use as directed. Only carefully selected, gourmet quality spices go into every jar of Spice Island. Trust every meal to Spice Island. Get all the mystery and adventure of the Clue game for your littlest detectives with Clue Junior for ages 6 to 10 from Parker Brothers. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.